Okay, so we can start the class. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about nosics. Okay, we are going to discuss about nosics. So in previous semester you used to study what is nosic. Okay, so today we are going to discuss what is gnosis. So tell me, gnosis. Okay, oh, we are dealing with steam gnosis. Okay, so we want to understand, first of all, we want to know what is meant by nozzle. Okay, so here we have to understand what is meant by nozzle. Then we will be studying few types of nozzles. Okay, then we have to find the equation for velocity of steam through nozzles. Okay. And also the mass flow rate. Okay, so we will be obtaining some formula. Okay, for V2, V3 like that. Okay, you will be understanding while the derivation. Okay, so using these formulas for velocity as well as mass flow rate, we will be solving problem. Okay, with using this, so question is very important in the point of view for the university examination. Okay, because in new times you can see that they used to ask the same question. Okay, which is very simple. If you know the SFE, you will be able to know, or you will be little bit easier in this derivation. Okay. So, nozzle. Okay, so we can define nozzle as a device, okay, which is designed to control, okay, which is defined to control the direction, okay, the direction or characteristics, okay, or cara of what fluid, okay, of fluid flow. Okay, so namak types area. So this is a device which is designed to control the direction, direction or the characteristics. So cara, you have to understand mainly here the control or the changes will be happening over the velocity of flow. Or velocity of the fluid flow. Okay, so we used to study in the S3, I think, in FM. Okay, first of all, at that time we study the divergent, convergent, and few types of nozzle. The same we are going to discuss, and after that we will be having a derivation over this particular topic. Okay, so hope you understand. So while taking, you have to I am writing this each things over this slide, because at that time you have to copy down. Okay, so you can write just steam nozzles. Okay, steam nozzles given heading, and you can write as, or not still, you can write the device designed to control the direction or characteristics of the fluid flow. Okay, so here then you can write what you can write. Steam nozzle. Okay. Here, steam nozzle we can define. Okay, first of all, we define the what is meant by nozzle. Then we can define, so steam nozzle as a passage. Okay, a passage of varying cross section. Varying cross section. Okay, vary cross section through which through which the heat, that is very important, okay, through which the heat energy of steam is converted into kinetic energy. Okay, so we have to write this both. Hope you are writing the passage of various cross section, varying cross section, comma, through which the heat energy of the steam is converted into kinetic energy and heat energy. Okay, so this is the thing. Okay, so now we are moving to the types of gnosis. Okay, hope you know it. First one we are discussing about converging or convergent gnosis. Okay, here the convergent gnosis. Okay, hope you know it very well. Okay, here what is happening? Convergent alle endana convergent. പറഞ്ഞതിന് ശേഷം യു കൻ ജസ്റ്റ് ലീവ് ലൈക്ക് 4 to 5 ലൈൻസ്. ഓക്കെ, ദെൻ യു കൻ റൈറ്റ് ദിസ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ ഈസ് കൺവേർജിങ്. ഓക്കെ, കൺവേർജിങ്. സോ okay, this is a example for converging. Okay, inlet and exit. Okay, so here what you have to understand that first the okay, starting from here it is a tapered. Okay, a tapered way. First here you can the taper. Okay, ivide endana oru well aanu. Okay, aa oru surface nu it is converging to a small സെക്ഷൻ. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഒരു ലാർജ് ടു സ്മോൾ സെക്ഷൻ ആണ് ഇതിൻ്റെ കേസിലേക്ക് വരുന്ന സമയത്ത്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഇൻ ദി സെക്കൻഡ് വൺ വി ആർ ഡിസ്കസിങ് അബൌട്ട് ഡൈവേർജൻസ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഹിയർ യു ഹാവ് ടു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് വാട്ട്. ഓക്കെ, ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി diverging. Okay, inlet and exit. Okay, inlet and exit. Okay, then the third V1 we are going to discuss about the convergent gnosis. Okay, here you have to understand that it will be a cluster of this both. Okay, so I am drawing that particular convergent over here. Okay, don't get confused, I am drawing here. Okay, so first one will be like this and there will be converging. Okay, from the it will be diverging. Okay, inlet. Okay, here throat. Okay, opinoid inlet and the outlet will be there, and the area or the cross section area, the smallest cross section area, adine nammal endana we will be calling that particular section as throat. Okay, throat. Okay, so this is the three classifications of what gnosis. Okay, three classifications of gnosis. Okay, so here we have to understand, as we discussed, like here the first section will be tapered, okay, or tapers to a small section, okay, small section, and the second one will be tapers to a large section. Okay, that is first one will be tapers to a small one, right? Okay, then that particular the section which having the smaller area, okay, smaller cross section, okay, then the second section it will be tapered to a larger one. Okay, here the taper is to a small section, and after that it is tapered to a large section. That is what I wrote here. Okay, so now we have to understand few things. Okay, few things that the steam flow through nozzle. Okay, steam flow through nozzle. Okay, that is what, if the steam is flowing through the nozzle, what all things is happening to that particular flow. Okay, so here we are considering, or we are assuming, okay, we are assuming the flow through the nozzle, or the steam flow through the nozzle is adiabatic. Okay, is adiabatic. Okay, that is we can say during the expansion. Okay, during the expansion of steam in the nozzle, neither any heat. Okay, you already know we are saying what is adiabatic process. The same scenario is here, there will be no heat supplied or rejected. Okay, so that is simply we can draw this nozzle, and while explaining you can just like this. Okay, so here you can just patch, or you can shade like this. Okay, which we can understand, which is mean by it is insulated. Okay, insulated. Okay, so you can show one small thing, one thing also, that is there will be no heat addition, there will be no heat rejection. Okay, there will be no heat rejection or no heat addition. Okay, so first our assumption or the thing we have to understand, that the flow of the steam nozzle will be flow through the nozzle will be adiabatic. Okay, so hope you're right. Okay, can I change?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next point is that, okay, while as the steam passes through nozzle, okay, it losses. Okay, what all things are known? Okay, so it loses its pressure. We all know that because the expansion is taking place and the pressure as well as the heat will be losing. Heat also losing. So you have to understand while steam is flowing over a or through a nozzle, the pressure as well as the heat loses or it flows. Okay, and the next one is that the work is performed by increasing the kinetic energy, increasing the kinetic energy of steam. Okay, our fourth point, the work is performed by increasing the kinetic energy of the steam. Okay, so here the work done, okay, the work done will be equal to the adiabatic heat drop. Okay. Okay. This is the four points we have to consider while considering the steam flow through nozzle. Okay. So the first one was adiabatic one. Okay. First one was the adiabatic one. Okay. The flow is adiabatic. And second one, the pressure as well as the heat decreases and the work will be performed by the increase of kinetic energy. Okay, and the fourth one is what? The work done is equal to the adiabatic heat drop. Okay, so this must be the four points you have to understand. Okay, so moving to the next, so now we are going to derive an equation for the velocity. Now we are going to derive velocity of steam. Okay, velocity of velocity of steam, okay, through nozzle. So for this derivation we are considering some assumptions. Okay, few assumptions are saying, the first one is that the steam is expanded isentropically. Okay, isentropically, which means reversible adiabatic. Alla mathralla endayirikum entropy will be constant. Okay, so reversible aanu r enne edidathu confusion aayikonda reversible and adiabatic process aanu. Okay, so the adiabatic means what? The heat transfer will be zero. Okay, our first assumption. Okay, so second one was the, I am writing the second one here. Okay, here is the first one and the second one I am writing here. I will choose another color so it will be little bit easier to understand. Okay, the second one was the steam enters the nozzle, the steam enters the nozzle with a high pressure. Okay, the steam is entering to the nozzle with the high pressure. Okay, and the velocity of inlet is negligible. Okay, that is, we are considering the V1 or the inlet velocity is zero, approximately equal to zero. This is because the velocity compared to the inlet and outlet. Okay, so comparing with the V2, it will be very small value. Okay, that is why we are just neglecting this V1. Okay, So, and the third, sorry, the fourth point is, the fourth point is, sorry. The fourth point is the steam leaves the nozzle. Steam leaves the nozzle at high velocity. Okay. Actually, this fourth one, okay, will be giving a conclusion for the first one. Okay. Sorry, the third one and the fifth. Okay. Fifth will be velocity, and you can write here as low pressure also. Sorry, high velocity and low pressure. Okay. So here, this is our assumption. Okay. No work is done during the flow through nozzle, flow through nozzle. Okay, that is W equal to zero. Okay, so these are the five assumptions we are making while deriving the velocity of steam through a nozzle. Okay, so first one was what? Okay, if it is the nozzle, okay, you just consider it as a nozzle, and what is happening here? The heat transfer or heat interaction, we can say like that, will be zero. Okay, the first one, and at the inlet, we can say that the flow will having a high pressure. Okay, high pressure. Okay, and the velocity will be, we are considering it as nearly zero. Okay, and the outlet or the exit of the nozzle will having the steam with the high velocity and low pressure, low velocity. Okay, consider the study anyone, and the vice versa. Okay, you can like, and the steam leaves the and the last one was here, the work done is zero. So this is the all assumptions we have made. Okay, so moving to the derivation, first one was, we can write, let us consider V1 equal to what? I am not going to write everything. Okay, velocity at inlet. Okay, inlet. Okay, which will be in meter per second. Okay, then V2, okay, velocity at trot. Okay, the same. And third one will be the velocity at a exit. Okay, similarly, we are considering H1, H2 and H3. Okay, and H1 will be the specific enthalpy, okay, of steam at inlet. Okay, outlet, sorry, trot and exit. Okay, this is the, both are same. Okay, you can write it, the specific enthalpy of the steam at inlet, trot and throat and exit. Okay, so moving, one more thing is that you can just write that here we are considering, I am writing here, okay, V3. Okay, this is what, the specific volume. Okay, specific volume at inlet, comma dot comma and exit. Okay, hope you write. You have to write it. Okay, just I am writing like this. So here is also. Okay, so v1, v2, v3, v1, v2, v3, h1, h2, h3. Okay, small v1, small v2, v3. Okay, this is for specific volume. Okay, so moving to the derivation part. So then okay, I'm here. One, two, three. Okay. V1, V2, V3. Okay. So you can draw that also. So applying SFEE. Okay, SFE flow convergent path. Convergent path. Okay, we are applying SFE over the convergent part. Okay, so we will be getting h1 plus v1 square by 2 plus. Okay, instead of I, we can give it as 1. It will be a little bit easier for you. G plus okay, so we made it. Okay, we will be getting like this. Okay, h1 plus v1 square by 2 plus z1 g plus dq by dm equal to h2 plus v2 square by 2 plus z2 g plus dw by dm. Okay. Okay, this is moving through the center. Okay, so here at the starting we made some assumptions. Okay, what is q equal to 0 as well as the w is also equal to 0. So this term and this term will be 0. Okay, and also we know that here the change in potential array. Okay, idana set 1 um set 2 inde case like edukkan samayathu same data aayirukum. So what will be happening also we know, or we, there will be yes. Okay, also set 1 g equal to set 2 g. Okay, that is what the change in potential energy is equal to 0. So it will be again 0 and this will be 0. So we will be getting the rest part as equal to h2 plus v2 square by 2. Okay, we will be getting like this. Okay, so here we are going to, okay, ഈ വി ടുണ്ട് നമ്മൾ എന്ത് ചെയ്യുക, നമ്മൾ ലെഫ്റ്റ് സൈഡിൽ ആക്കിയിട്ട് ബാക്കി എല്ലാ ടേംസിനും നമ്മൾ എന്ത് ചെയ്യണം, ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് സൈഡിലേക്ക് മാറ്റുകയാണ്. സോ വി വിൽ ബി ഗെറ്റിംഗ് ലൈക്ക്, സോറി, So we will be getting V2 square by 2 equal to H1 minus H2 plus V1 by V2. Okay. So we will get a E2 in the angle of opposite leg number of the room. It will be become H1 minus H2 plus V1 square. These two and two will be cancelled. Okay. So we will be getting an equation. For the V2 as minus H1 minus H2 plus V1 square. Okay. So okay, this is V, okay. Okay, so we obtain the formula for V2 as root of 2 into H1 minus H2 plus V1 square. Okay, so now we are going to find at S exit. Okay, at exit here. For the conversion part, okay. We will getting an equation as V3 equal to root of 2 into H1 minus H3 plus V1 square. Okay, so if V is neglected. V is neglected, we will be obtaining V3 as root of 2 into H1 minus H3. Okay. Okay. Hope you wrote. Anything you slide over now?
No, sir.
Yeah, this one. ഇത് എഴുതി പോണേ വരാം. അതായത് നാളെ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇത് വെക്കുന്ന സമയത്ത് ഇതെല്ലാം നോട്ട് കാണാം. നാളെ നിങ്ങളോട് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നു നമ്മളുടെ സൈക്കിൾസിന്റെ കാര്യത്തിലും അതേപോലെ തന്നെ അതുവരെയുള്ള കാര്യങ്ങൾ എങ്ങനെയൊക്കെയാണ് എഴുതേണ്ടത് എന്നുള്ളത് ഓൾറെഡി ഡിസ്കസ്ഡ് ആണ്. ക്ലാസ് തന്നെ നിങ്ങൾ ഓഫ്ലൈൻ മോഡിൽ തന്നെ വി ഓൾറെഡി റോട്ട് എവറിത്തിങ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ യു ഹാവ് ടു ബി സബ്മിറ്റഡ്. Okay, so and last some of you, okay, some of you ask about for the first slide. Okay, so here you can write nozzle. Okay, so nozzle has a device which is designed to control the direction, okay, or characteristics. Okay, you have to write characteristics of fluid flow. Okay, so mainly the characteristics means by velocity of flow. Okay, you can write that also, velocity flow. Okay, so after this, we can write what is meant by the steam nozzle. Okay, so we can define the steam nozzle and the passage of varying this by varying cross section. Okay, varying cross section in which the heat energy of steam is converted into kinetic energy. Okay, so hope you understand. Okay. So hope you understand. Just write down. It's okay. Okay, hope you wrote this everything. Okay, so highlight these two formulas. Okay, tell me the attendance.